So how many of you have seen the new Disney movie Encanto? I was talking with Casey this morning, and she has seen it three times. Three times! Now, I must confess, I could easily use my child as an excuse for viewing it more than once, but I have to say, I've watched it multiple times on my own. The dialogue is so rich, the animation is stunning, and the music, well, the music is by Lin-Manuel Miranda of Hamilton fame, so you know that it has to be fabulous. So, for those of you that haven't seen it, Encanto is about a family, the Madrigals, who have been given a miracle, a magical candle that has blessed their home and community with protection and special gifts. Not only is their house itself, which they lovingly call Casita, imbued with magic in a way that gives it some semblance of life, but each child born into the family is given magical gifts that continue to help the family and community. For example, Peppa can control the weather, Julieta can heal people with the food she cooks, Bruno, well, if you've seen the movie, you know that we don't talk about Bruno. Dolores has superhuman hearing, Camilo can shapeshift into different people, Antonio can talk to animals, Isabella can conjure beautiful flowers, Luisa has super strength. In many ways, this family can be seen as a perfect example of our scripture reading from today from 1 Corinthians 12. You know, the famous reading about being members of the body of Christ. St. Paul uses the human body as a metaphor for the body of Christ. But we could also use the Madrigal family from Encanto as a metaphor as well. St. Paul says, "For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ." This reading that we had this morning is actually pretty humorous because the Apostle Paul has the members of the body speaking to each other. If foot said, "I'm not elegant like hand, embellished with rings, I guess I don't belong to this body," would that make it so? If ear said, "I'm not beautiful like eye, clear and expressive, I don't deserve a place on the head," would you want to remove it from the body? If the body was all eye, how could it hear? If all ear, how could it smell? As it is, we see that God has carefully placed each part of the body where God wanted it. And then Paul goes on to say, "But I also want you to think about how this keeps your significance from getting blown up into self-importance. For no matter how significant you are, it is only because of what you are a part of. An enormous eye or a gigantic hand wouldn't be a body, but a monster. What we have is one body with many parts, each its proper size and in its proper place. No part is important on its own." Can you imagine eye telling hand, "Get lost, I don't need you." Or eye telling foot, "You're fired, your job has been phased out." As a matter of fact, in practice, it works the other way. The lower the part, the more basic and therefore necessary. You can live without an eye, for instance, but not without a stomach. When it's a part of your own body you are concerned with, it makes no difference whether the part is visible or clothed, higher or lower. You give it dignity and honor just as it is, without comparisons. If anything, you have more concern for the lower parts than the higher. If you had to choose, wouldn't you prefer good digestion to full-bodied hair? The way God designed our bodies is a model for understanding our lives together as a church, every part dependent on every other part. St. Paul is making it clear that no one is more important, more special, more talented, more anything in the body of Christ. All are important and all are needed. In the movie Encanto, the family uses their gifts to work together for the good of the village, for the good of the community. No one family member is seen as more important or more gifted than another. It really is a perfect way of understanding 1 Corinthians 12. But there's something I haven't told you yet about this movie. There's one family member who doesn't receive a gift like all the other children do. Maribel. In fact, Maribel is the protagonist of the whole film. Maribel is spunky and good-natured, and despite her deep desire to have her own gift to share, she tries to just be grateful, to simply be part of the amazing Madrigal family. As the movie progresses, the family that seems perfect from the outside begins to show cracks, figuratively and literally, as Casita starts falling apart. Viewers quickly see how certain characters feel overly defined by their gifts, which leads to family tensions and secrets. And while the matriarch of the family, Abuela Alma, continues to stress how everything is fine and the magic is strong, the family encounters challenges and the magic appears to grow weaker and weaker. Now, a lot of stuff happens in this movie that I'm going to skip over and not tell you about, but I do want to tell you that I think the movie makes the same move that St. Paul makes in his letter to the Corinthians. In 1 Corinthians, right after Paul talks about how everyone is different parts of the body with different gifts, and then he even lists some of those gifts, prophets, teachers, miracles, gifts of healings, then he heads off into chapter 13, which actually isn't part of our reading today, but I'm sure you'll recognize it. It goes like this. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. So after an entire chapter spent talking about gifts, here St. Paul slaps on a giant terms and conditions. Paul is saying that yes, gifts are wonderful, but they are not the most important. Whatever talent or skill or contribution you bring to the body, to the family, to the community, is important, but it's not the most important. Love. Love is the most important. If we put gifts, talent, or what people can do for us ahead of loving people, people themselves, then we have missed the point. If we think we are worthless, if we can't be of service, we don't understand that God truly loves us unconditionally. You are more than just your gifts. If we think we have to conform to what others think we should be or want us to be, then we are not truly loving ourselves as created in the image of God. Encanto ends with a song titled, All of You. The main part of this song says, the miracle is not some magic that you've got. The miracle is you. Not some gift, just you. The miracle is you. All of you. All of you. That's what Maribel learns in the end. She may not have received a gift in the same way that the rest of her family did, but she comes to realize that she is the gift, and her ability to love was all that she really needed. The part of the movie that brings me to tears every time I watch it is when the town folk show up to help rebuild Casita, the family home. They show up without magic, without gifts, and they sing. Lay down your load. We are only down the road. We have no gifts, but we are many. And we'll do anything for you. It's a dream when we work as a team. Now that's community. That's the body of Christ. We have no gifts, but we are many. A little later in that same song, Mirabel and Abuela sing together. I like the new foundation. It isn't perfect. Neither are we. That's true. That's true community. That's the real body of Christ. May we be inspired to fully love others and ourselves for who they and we truly are. Whether that is a foot or an ear or whatever. Whether we feel like we have gifts or not. And may we know that we are more than just our gifts. And that God's love is truly unconditional. Amen.